Well, hello everyone, this is Grandpa Terry with another Terry Don't story. You're gonna love this one. This was about when I almost got hit on the head, clobbered on the head with a tire iron. You know what a tire iron is? It's what we would use to take the nuts off of wheels when we had flat tires. You'd put it on and unscrew them and then change the tire and screw them back on with this iron. It was really strong. I'll tell you, I almost got clobbered over the head with one once. And it had nothing to do with cars. In the summers, when I didn't have to go to school, we got to go over to Clear Lake, Iowa. We had a place over there, a little cabin trailer house thing that we would stay in. And even though I was only, 12, 14 years old, I could take our boat out and drive around the lake. It was a good-sized lake, too. It's probably about 2 miles wide and 7 miles long. So it was a huge lake. We had so much fun water skiing on it and swimming and all sorts of things. And one day I thought I would ask my mom if I could take the boat across the lake to the Carnival. They had a carnival over there. Carnival's like a small fair. It's where there's all kinds of booths set up and you can test your skills throwing rings on bottles and throwing stuff and seeing your skill at accomplishing things so you can win prizes. That was a lot of fun and a lot of good food. Oh, cotton candy. A lot of cotton candy. Indian fry bread. And then people. You know, when I was 14 years old, there were some, shall I say, interesting people that probably caught my eye. So one day she said, yeah, go ahead, you can go ahead, but Terry, don't get in trouble. Watch yourself. I said, okay, sure, well, how about if I bring my brother Ron along with me? I'll take care of him. He's about 5 years younger than I. She said, well, be careful. Okay. So we jumped in the boat and took off and just kind of driving around on the way across the lake. And as soon as we got over there was what they called a city dock. So we could pull up to it, tie the rope around the post, and leave our boat there. It's free parking, no parking meters. So we did that and walked down, and as we were going down the dock, we were getting closer and closer to the carnival, and it was getting exciting, and it just looked like it was going to be a lot of fun, and I was thinking, okay, I got to be careful, take care of my little brother, watch what we're doing. So I kept that in mind, you know. Yeah, right. So as we were walking around, we saw those booths I was talking about. And they looked like fun, but one particular booth caught my attention. And we went over to take a look at it, and it had a lot of balloons in the booth. It was a balloon booth, of course. And it had 40 balloons up on the wall in the back. And then it had this big sign that says, break any 3 balloons and you get your pick of the prizes. And they had little teddy bears and little stuffed animals. And clear at the top, they had this great big teddy bear. So I went over and Ron was watching me, and I asked the guy that was working there, I said, is that right? Your sign says break any 3 balloons, and then I get to pick my prize? He said, yeah, that's right. Oh, okay. So I think it was, a dollar. And then he was going to give me 3 darts so I could break the 3 balloons. And I said, oh, no, that's all right. I only need 1. What? You only need 1 dart to break 3 balloons? That's right. So I think Ron kind of had an idea of what I was up to. So what I did is grab the dart and just kind of pretended to practice, you know, like I was really going to try and hit those balloons. And right before I threw it, probably about right here, I go like this. and I just flicked my wrist. Boom! And it goes right in this box full of balloons. And it goes pop, 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 pop. Because you see that earlier that morning, the carnival guy, the booth guy there, blew up all these balloons and had them ready to go for when some people actually popped some of the balloons that, well, they were over there on that wall. And I thought, man, that's a long ways to try to hit something. This looked a lot easier. So I did. I threw it in there and pop, 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 pop. And I said, I think, could I have that big bear up there? And that's when I saw the tire iron come out of nowhere. And he looked mad. And all I was doing was having fun. I wasn't really going to take the bear. It's kind of a check of his sense of humor. And he flunked. He didn't look like he had any sense of humor. So I kind of backed up, pushed her on back. And then he jumped up on the booth like a wild man. I mean, his face was just kind of mean. And he was showing his teeth like in the donkey story. He was really scary. And I thought, let's go around. Let's go to the boat. You go that way and I'll go this way. And sure enough, he jumped down, had that tire iron up in the air, and was swinging it, trying to hit me. So I took off running, and by then I was pretty used to zigging and zagging. If you've read my other stories, you know what I mean. So I zigged and I zagged and I went inside and around people, and he was still coming. And then I went straight, and I was just going to go straight to the boat and look back, and I saw him going the other way. He probably thought he should get back and watch his balloons and watch all the stuffed animals he had in there and take care of them. So I'm so glad he did. And Ron was a pretty fast runner, too. I think he beat me out there because I was zigging and zagging so much. So here was I said, get the rope, unhook the rope, let's go home. So he got, I think, the front rope, and I got the back rope, and we threw it in the boat, and I kicked the dock and got the boat out in the water. And oh, I was fumbling to get the key in because I was nervous, you know. I was afraid if I looked back again, he'd come and run and jump right in the boat with me. Really? And if he did, I didn't know what I would do then. I didn't want to jump in the water and leave the boat. So I finally got the key in. And, oh, I was hoping it would start. I turned the key on. You go, got it going. So usually when you take off from a dock, you're careful, you know, real careful. You watch everything, watch boats maybe coming in. But not this time. Oh. Oh, no. Whatever it was, I think it was over here. I took that handle, put the throttle to the, all the way, floored it. And then we took off and we started going. And this time I didn't fool around. I didn't zigzag and look around for fish and fishermen and skiers. I mean, I kept a vision so I wouldn't hit anybody and no one would hit me, but. Man, I took a beeline for home. And when we got home, I hurried up and backed it up into our boat lift and got it up and tied up, and we ran up the stairs. Oh, man, we were still huffing and puffing. And we got clear to the top and we ran inside our place. And, of course, I jumped in the chair and I looked at Ron and I said, wow, Ron, what a fun, neat day. And that's my balloon tire iron story.